RFD-TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses present Equestfest.
Hello and welcome to sunny Southern California for RFD-TV's exclusive coverage of the Tournament of Roses Equestfest presented by Wells Fargo. We're here at the Los Angeles Equestrian Center, just a few miles from where these horses and riders will be in the Rose Parade on New Year's Day. It's appropriate that we kick off our coverage of the Rose Parade with horses because it was in 1890 that horses were actually starting the Rose Parade when people said we're going to decorate our horses and show off to all our friends how beautiful the weather is here in Southern California. It was organized by the Valley Hunt Club Riding Group. The horses and riders come from across the country. Many of them left home before Christmas to get their horses settled in and comfortable. So 27 years ago, Equestfest was born to let the equestrians show off in this arena what the horses and riders cannot do on Colorado Boulevard on New Year's Day. You'll see horses of all breeds and sizes, including the champion Dakota Thunder Shires and the famous Budweiser Clydesdales and the hardy mules of the United States Park Service. Our arena announcer should be familiar to you. Jan Carl is the host of RFD-TV's Small Town Big Deal. And you may know Carson Kressley as the Emmy Award-winning TV personality and designer, but you may not know that he's also a champion equestrian. We'll send it down to our arena announcers, Jan and Carson.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your MCs for this year's Equestfest. They don't just talk the talk, they ride the ride. Mounted on a beautiful thoroughbred champion named Yukon is the co-host of Small Town Big Deal, airing on Thursday nights on RFD-TV and syndicated on stations across the country. Say hello to Jan Carl. And riding a former world grand champion, Casey's Final Countdown, one of the fabulous Scripps Miramar Saddlebreds, is Emmy Award-winning TV personality, New York Times best-selling author, fashion designer, and multiple world champion equestrian, Carson Kressley.
I'm Jan Carl.
Hey everybody, and I'm Carson Kressley, and this is Casey's Final Countdown, and we're glad you're here for the Equestfest. Are you guys ready to have a great show? Yes.
So, hey, let's hear it for Dawson again, our band.
Give it up for our band, Dawson.
That's right. Did y'all bring your dancing shoes or your dancing boots? Oh wait, did you bring your dancing shoes or your dancing boots?
Yes.
All right. Well, and how about those knights from medieval times? Give it up. All right. They will both be back a little bit later in the program. You know, Carson, we are here to honor the riders and the horses that will be riding in the 127th Rose Parade. And for
amazing.
Some of them, yeah, they have ridden before. Some of those horses and people are veterans, such as yourself.
I know. This is my second year doing the parade with Scripps Miramar Ranch, but we also have some groups that have never done the parade before, some people who have never gone down Colorado Boulevard. So you guys are going to see some acts that nobody else is going to get to see. So you're in for a real treat today.
That's right. You know, horses have been a part of the Rose Parade since day one. So you being here today and the entire show, it is an honor and I guess a tip of our hat to a tradition that is over 100 years old. So what do you say, Carson? Should we go dismount, take our seats and get the show on the road?
Yeah, let's get it started and we'll get ready to welcome the Norco Cowgirls.
All right, all right. Enjoy the show.
Yeah, she's country. She's from a cowboy mood, Stuart
girls know how to ride. What do you all say? Ladies and gentlemen, entering the arena is the United States Marine Corps Mounted Color Guard, proudly carrying the Stars and Stripes, accompanied by the Marine Corps Eagle, Globe, and Anchor. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as the colors are presented. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Members of the military in uniform may salute.
The Marine Corps Color Guard is based at MCLB Barstow and is the only remaining Mounted Color Guard in the Marine Corps today. Our heroes are mounted on America's living legends, wild Mustangs from the Bureau of Land Management's Adopt-a-Horse program, and are under the command of Gunnery Sergeant Antonio Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, I will ask that you please remain standing. We present Belinda Gale to perform our national anthem. Sierra Foothills near Sequoia National Park. Along with being a gifted singer and songwriter, Belinda's warm and vibrant personality captures the spirit of the West. Ladies and gentlemen, America's Western sweetheart, Belinda Gale, performing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
for the United States Marine Corps Color Guard.
American spirit, the Wells Fargo Stagecoach, with George Lane handling the ribbons and proudly carrying this year's Tournament of Roses president Michael Matheson and his lovely wife Anne. Seeking their fortune. Wells Fargo used various means of transportation, steamship, railroads, and where railroads weren't available, yep, horses and stagecoaches to get that job done and provide its customers with superior service.
Now, to carry passengers and express across the continent, Wells Fargo used sturdy stagecoaches built by the Abbott Downing Company of Concord, New Hampshire. The stagecoach's egg-shaped body rested on leather thorough braces. The rounded design gave the 2,200-pound coach a rocking motion when in transit. Because of this, Mark Twain described the stagecoach as a cradle on wheels.
You know, the coaches were pulled by a team of 6 horses that were replaced every 12 miles, hold 9 passengers, with 9 more sitting on top. Each traveler allowed 25 pounds of baggage, a little bit, hard to imagine today.
And a special welcome to Wells Fargo Home Mortgage Area Manager Larry Garcia, who's retiring after 15 years with the company.
All right.
Taking part in the Tournament of Roses Parade since 1988, the concept for the next group joining us is over 1,000 years old.
That's right, Carson, and since 1986, a visit to medieval times in Buena Park has truly become a California tradition.
You know a little bit about the medieval times tradition yourself, don't you, Jan?
Well, I do. Besides going to the castle in Buena Park, I'm very lucky. My daughter, Catherine, is going to get to ride as the princess this year in the Rose Parade. So if you're on the parade route, give a shout out to Catherine.
Oh, fantastic. Well, then maybe you should introduce the medieval times team.
Oh, I would love to. You mean those knights of the realm? All right. My lords and ladies. Here from medieval times in Buena Park, we welcome the Master of Horse, Sir Retta Garza, joined by Lady Bethany Bernatsky.
Just heard Jan Carl say that her daughter was going to be riding in the Tournament of Roses Parade, and this is Catherine Carl Sears, and you are an accomplished equestrian, but you will be riding as a princess.
I will. It's a dream come true to ride with not only medieval times, but in the Rose Parade. I mean, I've grown up watching the Rose Parade every year, and I'm a lifelong fan of these amazing horses and the talented knights, too.
And these horses are so highly trained. Will you be riding your own horse, which I know you keep here at the Equestrian Center, or will you be riding one of the medieval times horses?
I am lucky enough to ride one of their incredible horses that they're award-winning. They travel all over the country. They have 9 castles across the states, and over 50 million people have come to watch their show, and I am so blessed and am so incredibly excited to ride with them.
Well, bundle up on New Year's Day, and we'll all be watching for you. All of our viewers on RFD TV are so proud of your mom and what she does, and we will be proud of you as well.
Oh, thank you so much, Pam.
All right, go get on that horse.
Will do.
Field of battle.
Thank you.
ranches, the largest in Sanger, Texas. It's over 250 acres, and the breeding program there makes Medieval Times the largest breeder of Andalusians in all of North America.
And their beautiful Andalusian stallions. Give him a round of applause. He's taking a bow for you.
I think we need to bow ourselves, shall we?
Sure.
I think we shall also bow. Beautiful job, just magnificent. And of course, you can go to Buena Park and see this anytime you want.
And get an oversized turkey leg.
Absolutely.
I mean, come on.
I know.
What wins?
And eat with your hands.
I'm there.
And maybe get a carnation kissed by a knight. You're there.
I'm there. You sold me, Jan.
Beautiful job. Woo!
Beautiful horses.
Oh my gosh, they are. I will tell you, Catherine is so thrilled to be riding one of them this year.
I know.
She's going to be riding Echo.
Oh, the one that was in here.
Yes.
Okay.
Not so sure it'll be doing that leap down Colorado.
I hope not.
No, probably not.
That's probably not a good idea.
No, but perhaps a beautiful Spanish walk.
Exactly.
All right. Well, now entering the Equestfest arena is another longtime veteran of the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, Benny Martinez, along with friends and family.
Now, folks, New Year's Day will be Benny's 34th year riding and roping in the Tournament of Roses parade. Benny Martinez is the group's marshal, and riding along with him are his daughter, Gloria, Samuel Alarcon, Alex Medina, Rafael Mendez, and Roberto Ramirez.
Now, Benny and his wife, Rosa, have performed throughout the U.S. over the years. They have performed in Las Vegas, in my home state of Missouri, in Branson, Missouri, and, get this, at the Winter Olympics.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Cristo a las puertas está. Cristo resucitarán primero. Su palabra me dice que pronto, un día en las nubes, le voy a encontrar.
Now, Benny has done that along the parade route for more than 30 years. Okay, I can't even stand on a horse, nor can I do that with a rope, and I certainly couldn't do both at the same time.
Right.
How about you?
I can't even rub my head and pat my belly at the same time, so no, I couldn't do that for sure.
Benny, you are amazing.
Give it up for Benny Martinez, everyone. Now, Benny says that throughout the 30-plus years that he and his group have been riding in the parade, they have seen many floats describing the beauty of God's creation. But he wants us to never forget who gave us the privilege and joy of finding our own adventure among the natural beauty. As Benny reminds us, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
And the horse.
And the horse, thank you.
Well said, Benny. You know, Benny started riding at 3.5 years old. Carson, what about you?
I think I started when I was about 4.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just now getting good.
Oh, stop. Well, Benny's father taught him his first road trip then when he was 4 years old. Now, some of the ropes that Benny uses are 70 feet long.
Wow. And some of the roping skills Benny is performing here today and along the parade route include the wedding ring, the mirror, the Texas skip, and the umbrella.
Earlier, we saw our Tournament of Roses president ride in on the Wells Fargo stagecoach, and I got a chance to talk to him just before he hopped aboard. Mike Matheson is this year's Tournament of Roses president. You grew up here in Pasadena and have been a volunteer on this committee for nearly 40 years. Talk about what it means to this community.
Well, the spirit of volunteerism is just something that Pasadena is very proud about. And joining the Tournament of Roses Association and be part of something that's global is an opportunity that I don't think anybody could resist, I would hope.
As the president, you get to choose the theme and the grand marshal. Talk a little bit about how important that is to you and your family.
Well, that is some easier than others, and Find Your Adventure kind of morphed out of the centennial celebration of the National Park Service, and their theme is Find Your Park. And Find Your Adventure, I think it takes it even bigger, wider, and can, I think, motivate other sponsors, float participants, and others to find their adventure through our parade. The Grand Marshal, Ken Burns was just number one on the list from the get-go. And we are so honored that Ken Burns, a documentarian, a historian, a person that brings America to life on the screen, I'm so glad that he accepted, and we couldn't be more excited to see him.
And talk about Equestfest and how important horses are to the Tournament of Roses.
What started out as horse-drawn carriages has morphed into more of the history, bringing history to life, the costumes, and then we also have the future because we have the endurance riders now, kind of the X Games of equestrian. So we're pretty excited about seeing all of that.
Well, we're excited to see what's coming up next here at Equestfest. Thank you for stopping by, and we'll be back with more right after this.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more from the Equestfest on RFD TV. You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
Welcome back to the Los Angeles Equestrian Center and our coverage of Equestfest. Of course, this is RFD TV's exclusive coverage. We hope you're enjoying what you see of these horses in the arena and that you'll join us on New Year's Day and tell your friends to watch RFD TV for all of our coverage, because we cover the floats and the bands and, of course, the equestrians. You might know that I host Gentle Giants on RFD TV, which is on Sundays and Wednesdays. So you've probably seen this six horse hitch that's getting ready to roll into the arena right now. This is Dakota Thunder Shires. The Shires are closely related to the Clydesdales. And take a look at this beautiful six horse hitch from South Dakota.
Dakota Thunder Shires was a dream of owner Houston Hago since 1991, when he saw a black Shire hitch at the National Western Stock Show in Denver. Hago, a lifelong horse lover, met Joe Barron of Iona, Minnesota, and they developed the foundation for creating the Dakota Thunder Shires hitch. Hago and Barron have worked together to buy horses from all over the United States to create a dynamic and competitive hitch in Dakota Thunder. 2012 was their inaugural year entering show competition, and it was an exciting season of acquired knowledge with some welcomed early successes that they hope will continue to strengthen their hitch. They love exhibiting and sharing the Shire breed as a proud part of the draft horse world. For Hago, it's truly a dream come true. The Shire horse traces back to the English Great Horse and was also known as the War Horse. Throughout its history, Shires have been known for pulling brewery wagons and delivering ale to pubs. Shires once numbered well over a million, but mechanization and the automobile led to a rapid decline to just a few thousand horses today. Her Majesty the Queen of England serves as patron to the preservation and promotion of the Shire horse. Dakota Thunder is proud to show these majestic horses.
Cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel.
Well, I mentioned that these are Shire horses, and let me tell you a little bit about how the six horse hitch works. The horses out in the front, those are called the lead horses, and those horses are the lighter of the six horses. Each of them weigh almost a ton, but typically the lead horses are the most animated, and they are the superstars of the hitch, so to speak. The middle two horses are the swing horses, and those are the horses that have got to kind of slow down and stop the wagon. And then the biggest horses of the hitch are the wheel horses. The wheel horses are the heaviest. They really pull the load. And when they're in a six horse hitch competition, which is what we cover on Gentle Giants many times, they are judged on their animation. They're judged on how their headsets are level side by side. Truly, when you're looking across the hitch, you should only see three horses. They should be that perfectly matched in size and in their animation. Joe Barron, as well as being the driver of this six-horse hitch, is also a school teacher up in Minnesota. They left home on December 22nd and made their way here, spending Christmas on the road in Dumas, Texas, of all places. And they said they were very happy that Santa Claus found them. But each week, we hope that you enjoy RFD TV's coverage of Gentle Giants, where you'll see horses like this, heavy horses that pull the load. Mr. Houston Hago and his wife, Judith, who own this hitch, are so proud. It's been a bucket list item for them to have these horses here at the Tournament of Roses Equestfest. And on New Year's Day, they will all be riding in the wagon, the entire family. And they say they are so proud that they bring a little bit of bright light in the equine world to South Dakota, which, of course, is mostly known for Mount Rushmore.
Joe Biron and the Dakota Thunder Shires.
And I see those blue ribbons. I think those are definitely award-winning animals. And, of course, drivers, too. We should say the drivers are very handsome as well. I know we're just bragging on the horses.
The Tournament of Roses for extending their invitation
matched also.
To the 2016 Rose Bowl Parade. Thank you for this incredible opportunity to the Dakota Thunder Shires.
Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the Dakota Thunder Shires, all the way from South Dakota.
Thank you, gentlemen. Were they beautiful or what?
Love them.
Yeah, maybe I want two.
You should get two, for sure.
They had six.
You could get two. You've got room for it.
All right, now, it was an adventure then. After a battle of June of 1877, a band of over 750 Nez Perce, many of them women, children, and elders, began a trek for life, pursued by elements of the U.S. Army. Though greatly outnumbered, the Nez Perce continually outmaneuvered the Army and won several battles on their flight to Canada.
An adventure reborn. Each year since 1965, the Appaloosa Horse Club holds a trail ride that covers 13 sections of the Nez Perce Trail, riding 100 miles a year of the 1,300-mile Nez Perce journey from Oregon to the Bear Paw Mountains. The ride connects a tragic history to the love of national parks fostered by the Nez Perce.
Adventure as well, to follow the footsteps of the forefathers, to celebrate the spirit of the Appaloosa horse and Native American Indian cultures along with the horse today. The Calzona Appaloosa Horse Club presents a colorful breed with deeply embedded roots.
The Calzona Appaloosa Horse Club celebrates over 60 years of history. The Appaloosa is a distinctive breed known for its colorful spotted coat and marking patterns. Membership continues to promote this versatile and family-oriented breed in various equestrian events and disciplines. Find one near you for the best adventure ever.
Thank you.
As you see before you, 12 riders are in a traditional celebration of the horse parade, costumed in their finest hand-beaded regalia to honor the Appaloosa. The Calizona Appaloosa Horse Club follows the dreams of their forefathers to celebrate the spirit of the Appaloosa horse with regard to its Native American ties, along with thousands of Appaloosa owners that enjoy the breed today. It's a colorful breed with deeply embedded roots. Each equestrian rides in authentic trappings and hand-beaded regalia that it would have been seen well over 100 years ago.
Appaloosa horses carried Chief Joseph and his band of Nez Perce on that 1,200-mile odyssey towards Canada for freedom that fell a few miles short. It was almost the demise of the spotted horses. Years later, the dreams of a few horsemen ensured that the beautiful Appaloosa prospered by founding the Appaloosa Horse Club 75 years ago.
Calizona demonstrates that their dreams have resilience and life and to a well-founded breed today.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Calizona Appaloosa Horse Club.
Dreams come true, and the Calizona Appaloosa Horse Clubs hope you all have an happy new year.
I love it. How many of y'all caught that? Did you catch it?
Are we going to spot them in the parade?
Oh.
I'm here every Thursday. Try the view.
Very good. Beautiful.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, joining us for the second time, please welcome the Wells Fargo Stagecoach, this time carrying some very special cargo, the 2016 Tournament of Roses Queen Erica Karen Winter and her royal court.
Queen Erica is from Pasadena and attends Flint Ridge Preparatory School. Erica is part of the cheer and dance team, the student senate, and is a middle school commissioner. She is a peer counselor, and also a volunteer instructor for autistic dance classes. Erica is the daughter of Tim and Christine Winter.
Joining Erica in the Wells Fargo stage is her royal court. A student at Flint Ridge Sacred Heart Academy, Rose Princess Bryce Marie Blakewell. Bryce serves as the president of the Black Student Union and volunteers within a daycare for disabled children. Also joining them is Rose Princess Natalie Brianne Hernandez Barber. She's a senior at Alverno High School and lives in Pasadena. Natalie serves as an Alverno ambassador and works with the campus ministry. Joining them also is Rose Princess Rochelle Chacal Renee Liu. She is a senior at San Marino High School and lives in Arcadia. Rochelle serves as the president and founder of the Leadership Experience Opportunity Club and captain of both the speech and debate teams.
We also welcome Rose Princess Donnelly Elizabeth Marquez. She's a senior at Blair High School and lives in Pasadena. Donnelly enjoys soccer, also writing poems, singing, and dancing. She currently works for the Ambassador Youth Program. Rose Princess Regina Marche Pullins is a senior at Maranatha High School. She lives in Altadena. And finally, Rose Princess Sarah Sumiko Shocklin, a senior at La Cañada High School. Woo, let's hear it for the 2016 Rose Queen and her court.
Give them a big hand, everybody.
You know, I think it's pretty obvious that these girls are chosen not just for their beauty, but their commitment to their high schools and to their communities. Let's give them a round of applause. I think they are an example for all young women all across, not just California, but the country.
And next up, we have a piece of old California history as we welcome the arrival of the Hermanos Banuelos Charro team.
De bronce soy poeta y campesín, por mis venas corre sangre, sangre noble, sangre de indio. Soy puro zacatecano, mexicano por herencia, tierra de mis abuelos, mis padres, mi sangre de raza azteca. Y la mujer que quiero de ser trigueña, morena como la tierra de mi patria mexicana. Y la mujer que quiero para adorarla tiene que ser morena como la Virgen Guadalupana, porque soy como soy, buitito corazón, 100% mexicano, mariachi, banda, tequila y son, porque soy como soy, mi totero y querendón, 100% mexicano, mariachi, banda, tequila y son.
Okay. Now, this team is composed of brothers, first cousins, and some close friends that are professional Mexican charros and rope trickers. The group performs horse and rope tricks in shows and also compete in professional charrerías. The Banuelos Charro team was founded in 1995 by the Banuelos brothers and friends. The group has attended several community events through the years. Now, those horses and those rope tricks are performed by the riders. The Banuelos Charro team participates in parades throughout Southern California and also has participated in several Rose parades. You know, those costumes they use are 100% handmade in Mexico and also in the U.S. It consists of embroidered slack-style pants. This is your part, Carson.
Right.
Long sleeves. And the hat is a typical charro sombrero made out of authentic rabbit fur and decorated with different colored patterns. Each rider wears authentic rawhide chaps and boots.
I like it. Now, the saddles used by the riders were handcrafted in Zacatecas, Mexico. The fuste of the saddle is made out of mesquite wood wrapped in goat skin for both physical appearance and to provide strength to the saddle. The fuste has a large horn that is designed mainly for roping cattle. The leather is authentic rawhide decorated with patterns and stainless steel buttons. The Banuelos Charro team enjoys participating in community events where horses can be introduced to children as well as to adults, helping others experience horses firsthand and allowing the opportunity to ride one.
So Carson, next year, you, the saddlebred, and a rope, what do you say?
I'll have to work on that.
I'll have to work on that.
I have 12 months. I think I can do it. I'm gonna start volunteering with the Hermanos Banuelos.
Yes, you're inspired. And this is the next generation I see right here as well.
As you can see, there is a lot going on back there with Hermanos Banuelos. This is what a charreada is all about. The charros showing off the rope tricks, showing off their horsemanship skills and exactly what those horses could do in those authentic saddles and costumes. And we'll be back with more from Equestfest in just a moment.
You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
Welcome back to the Los Angeles Equestrian Center. I'm Pam Minnick. When I was a little girl growing up, I used to watch the Rose Parade from my home. And when I got to have a horse, I chose a Palomino. And the reason I chose a Palomino is because when I watched the Rose Parade, I saw this next group, the Long Beach Mounted Police, and they all ride matching Palominos.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again. Just my children.
Beginning in 1946, for 69 consecutive years, Long Beach Mounted Police has ridden in the Rose Parade. Long Beach Mounted Police not only rides in several California parades each year, but their troop has ridden in parades in Hawaii, Canada, Mexico, Central and South America, and in presidential inauguration parades in Washington, D.C. In addition to riding in parades, they also visit hospitals and nursing homes, and this year they were honored to carry the lighted torch into the opening ceremony of the Special Olympics.
In parades and other events, the Long Beach Mounted Police riders proudly carry the American flag to honor our country, our military, and the American public. Their beautiful Palomino horses, colorful parade costumes, sterling silver saddles and tack, and their enthusiastic interaction with the audience, either at Equestfest or in the Rose Parade or any other events, are a strong and unique visual enhancement for audiences. Their president is Robert Lorbeer, and it was Robert's lovely wife, Belinda, who shared the national anthem with us today.
Fantastic.
Multi-talented family.
They are. And as always, the Long Beach Mounted Unit is pleased to participate in Equestfest today and wish all of the audience in the stands and on television a very happy new year.
And I'm proud to be an American.
ladies and gentlemen, the Long Beach Mounted Unit.
Okay, every time I hear that song, it gets me.
Me too.
Same with you guys? Yeah, it's beautiful. It's a day to celebrate horses and being an American. Now, I would say, Carson, everybody here today loves their horses, and indeed, they love to ride.
They do. But most of us ride a few hours at most each week, and maybe a few miles in the saddle.
Yeah. Well, how about this? The next group joining us, they like to go out for a nice, 100-mile ride.
Wow.
Yeah. The American Endurance Ride Conference. Here is Paul Sidio, who's going to tell us all about it.
The American Endurance Ride Conference is the governing body of endurance rides in the United States. This group of endurance riders formed the parade group to promote and educate the public about our amazing sport. These riders and horses represent the adventurers who choose their magic carpets to be a horse. The motto of our sport is to finish is to win, because each rider, the meaning of to win, cannot be defined with trophies or ribbons. It is in the accomplishment of a goal set by their own standards. To these riders, to be fit to continue on after 25 miles, 50 miles, or 100 miles in 24 hours, that is winning.
Saddle up your horses.
Now welcome the riders of the American Endurance Riders Parade Riders Group, led in by Group Marshal Gail Pena. Following Gail will be riders wearing red, who are legends of our sport. John Park and Remington, Connie Creech on LS Chardonnay Bay, and Karen Chatton on Granite Chief. Each of these legends represents tens of thousands of competition miles, many of these 100 miles in one day. And now the rest of our parade riders group, Sandy Harris, Linda McKinley, Anna Wolf, Amanda Gibson, Lisa Siderman, Carlos Siderman, Laura Rotowski, Alessandra Dyrnik, Becky London, Veronica Dyer, Camille Monson, Krista Ternage, Phyllis Keller, Shelley Child, Lynn Leonard, Carrie Tully, and Dale Raymond, and Tina Suplee. These riders are demonstrating a working trot, which in endurance is the most common gait that we use. An average speed of 5.5 miles an hour or better is required to complete a ride in the allowed time. Each one of these riders knows what it means to find your adventure. Endurance riding is a very adventurous sport, full of goals to meet and challenges. There are dreams to fulfill, such as riding the world-famous Tevis Cup 100 miles in a day, climbing Cougar Rock, just examples of the many adventures that can be found in endurance riding. Our horses are our partners in these adventures. They take us far and away over mountains high and valleys low. Endurance rides are held in locations known for their natural beauty, such as our national parks and forests, from coast to coast and around the world. AERC strives to preserve our nation's trails and historic routes. Anywhere there are trails, we are there to ride them. Riders can retrace the trails ridden by our forefathers.
For the second year in a row, the equestrian chairman here at the Tournament of Roses is Ellen Swaggerty. And Ellen, you've got to be proud at how this looks this year and the new groups that you've added.
Oh, absolutely. We're just so excited this year. We have 19 equestrian units. Three are new. We have as far away as South Dakota, the Thundershires, and we have a group from Fort Sill. And it's just wonderful. We're featuring an American endurance riding group that basically do marathons on horses. So it's interesting group this year.
And of course, coming up a little later are the Budweiser Clydesdales, and you called them the rock stars of this event.
Oh, absolutely. Who doesn't like the Clydesdales? They're absolutely gorgeous, and they actually stop traffic. They really do. Where anybody is, they just stop them.
You told me earlier that you're always looking for new groups, and how can they apply? Because I know a lot of people, it is their bucket list to be in the Tournament of Roses Parade.
Absolutely. We're looking for new groups that offer diversity and different breeds, and you can get on tournamentofroses.com and get an application in the early spring. And so, we would entertain all new applicants.
Well, thank you for having RFD TV back here once again this year.
Thank you for being here. It's been wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you, Ellen Swaggerty, our equestrian chair. And we'll be back with more from Equestfest right after these messages.
You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
Welcome back here to the Los Angeles Equestrian Center. We hope you are enjoying our coverage of Equestfest. Coming into the arena now are the Spirit of the West riders, and you won't want to miss what they've got in store for you. A little shooting action.
All right, so some of you may already know this, but it is 935 members that make up the Tournament of Roses Association, and they contribute 80,000 volunteer hours each year to pull all of this off. Wow. Well done. All right, all you cowboys and cowgirls, or wannabe cowboys and cowgirls, I think it's time for a little Wild West shooting display. What do you say?
Okay, how many of you have found your adventure? Our next act is from the Spirit of the West Riders, men and women who found their adventure by learning the skills of our Western heroes. Today, they'll bring back the thrilling days of the old-time Wild West shows. In these spectacles, the most popular acts were the trick and fancy shooting and the daredevil horseback riding feats performed by such legendary entertainers as Buffalo Bill Cody, Pawnee Bill, and Annie Oakley.
And today, our modern-day Rough Riders are proudly representing the John Wayne Cancer Foundation. Let's first welcome the Spirit of the West's Greg Worley. Greg Worley is a hot competitor in the fast action sport of cowboy mounted shooting. He's also appeared in a number of Western films and documentary television programs, such as the History Channel's Wild West Tech and National Geographic Channel's recent hit, Billy the Kid, New Evidence. Greg is riding his quarter horse, Peppy, who has also been seen in a number of television shows and movies.
Now, Greg will ride the course firing his Colt 45 revolver at the row of targets, then holster his six-gun, draw his second peacemaker, and ride and shoot the second row of targets. Greg, make your ride when you're ready.
Thank you.
everybody.
All right. Way to go, Greg and Peppy. Woo! Oh, there's some love for Peppy, too. All right, setting up for the next act. You know, Greg did pretty well. I'd say pretty much 100%. But you know what? There's two gals here that say shooting and riding is not just a man's game. Now, these gals are going to have a little friendly shootout competition themselves just to see who is deserving of the title of Side Saddle Queen of the West. Let's bring them in now. Come on in, ladies. Woohoo!
Now here's Lori Brown Smith on the Red Roan Quarter Horse. Lori is a women's rifle mounted shooting world champion. You've also seen her in many of the History Channel's Wild West Tech episodes. Riding the dark buckskin quarter horse is Lawless Linda, AKA Linda Spannenberger. I know that Linda is a World Cowboy Mounted Shooting Association three-time world champion cowgirl and is a heavily decorated lady shooter in the sport of cowboy mounted shooting.
We will get them lined up and watch them as they race through the course, firing their Colt 45s at the targets, side saddle. The first rider to finish the course with the most hits will be our winner. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you, you will not see ladies riding and shooting from side saddle like this anywhere else in the country.
The Spirit of the West Riders, Marshal Phil Spangenberger, will fire the starting shot when he knows the girls are ready.
All right, well, it looks like Lori Brown Smith has been our winner today. Congratulations, Lori!
Now let's bring back Greg Worley to join up with the ladies. Let's give a round of applause for our Spirit of the West Riders, fitting tributes to the John Wayne Cancer Center Foundation and the memory of the Duke. Watch for them on January 1st as they ride in the Tournament of Roses Parade once again for their 24th year.
Well, we've been enjoying their voices as the hosts of the Equestfest from In the Arena. And earlier today, I got a chance to talk to Jan Carl and Carson Kressley. Well, you've been listening to their voices, and now you get to see them close up. Jan Carl of RFD TV's Small Town Big Deal. And, of course, Carson Kressley, as we talked about, he's an Emmy Award-winning actor, actor, and a wonderful equestrian
I'm
as well.
Okay. I'm okay. Don't get too close. Don't get too close. I sound better than I look.
First, Jan, we're going to talk about you. I didn't realize you're from Pasadena, so the Tournament of Roses has got to be in your blood.
It really is. It's completely in my blood. All my neighbors are volunteers. One year I got to be a float judge, and then I've broadcast it for CBS and HGTV. So, yeah, pretty much Roses and New Year's Day is our day in Pasadena.
And this is your second year to be the MC here at Equestfest, and you've got quite a horse background.
Well, I'm not like Carson by any means. No. I mean, I rode, as a youngster and all of that. But it's been a few years. So when they asked us, when Lee asked us to ride into the ring at the beginning of the show, I was like, oh, okay, I better go get on and practice. So you hopefully I did okay. Do I get a thumbs up from
yes,
earlier?
Yes, you do. You get a thumbs up. And talk about Catherine, your daughter. She'll be riding in the parade.
Oh, my gosh. Medieval times. She gets to ride with all those handsome knights and those amazing, amazing Andalusian stallions. And they've been so gracious. And, you know, it's like RFD. I mean, medieval times is family fun. And we just feel so lucky that she's going to be the princess that day waving. So give her a high
holler on New Year's Day.
We will. And lastly, Small Town Big Deal. What's your favorite equestrian story you've done for that show?
Oh, you know, and it's fitting because they're here, is when we did the story on the breeding farm for the Clydesdales. And when we were there in Boonville, Missouri, Rodney and I got to be in the middle of 23 baby foals. And I was in heaven. I kissed them all. Rodney doesn't kiss them, but I kissed them for both of us.
Well, the Budweiser Clydesdales are coming up in just a little bit. And maybe you'll see one of those babies that has grown up to be in the hit.
I know. I sort of feel like a mama now. You know, once you've seen them as a baby, you're like, oh, yeah, that's my baby Clydesdale.
Okay. Thank you for what you've done here today. And Carslin, we got to see you ride last year.
Yes.
And we'll get to see you ride again with Scripps Miramar in just a little bit. Mm-hmm. But first of all, talk about riding the parade last year.
The parade was a bucket list thing. I mean, of course, you know, that's like, you know, growing up, you would like turn the TV on New Year's morning and we would watch that as a family and just, you know, want to see all the floats. And me, I was like, no, look at the horses. And so when Michelle McFarlane of Scripps Miramar Ranch said, hey, would you ride with us last year? I said, let me think about that. Yes. And I got to ride a beautiful saddlebred mare named Flurry, and I've been lucky enough to show saddlebred horses all my life, so I was very at home. And it was just, it's a magical experience. When the jet fighters, you know, fly over and start the parade, I was thinking, oh, I hope my horse is cool with this. She was. And I literally, like, I got goosebumps, and I started to get, like, a little teary. It's a very emotional experience because it's a piece of Americana. It's a really, really special thing to be a part of.
One of the things that Michelle does every year is change up her theme of Scripps Miramar here. This year, it's all cowboy all the way. Talk about your outfit.
Yeah. She is so fantastic with, you know.
I sound like you. Talk about your outfit.
I know. Tell me what you're wearing. This year, because the theme of the parade is Find Your Adventure, Michelle was really inspired by our national parks, and she has wanted a passenger wagon from Yellowstone Park, an antique one from the 1800s, since she was a little girl. I mean, that's what she's wanted. And she found one in Wisconsin at an auction or for a private sale, and the guy agreed to sell it to her, so she has it. And that's been the theme for our whole unit this year, is exploring and finding adventure in the American West. So we are riding in silver saddles, highly collectible. They're made by Bolin Saddlery. They did all the saddles for Gene Autry and Roy Rogers. So there's a lot of Hollywood history here. And I get to wear these fun chaps with the sterling silver medallions. So I'm really having fun with the clothes this year.
All right. And we'll see you out there on your saddlebred in just a few moments.
You will.
We'll be back with more of Equestfest right after this.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more from the Equestfest on RFD TV. You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
We hope you're enjoying Equestfest and that you'll join us on New Year's Day for the Tournament of Roses Parade. You know, RFD TV shows you all the floats, all the bands, and all the horses. And speaking of horses, here come the beautiful saddlebreds of Scripps Miramar Ranch, led by Carson Cressley.
Miramar saddlebreds.
Go, Ben.
There's Carson now. Woo! Carson is riding Casey's Final Countdown. You know, Casey is an American saddlebred, and we've been told is one of those enormously talented horses that comes along only once in a lifetime. Casey's Final Countdown was actually born in South Africa. He spent his growing up years running wild on the veld. And then Michelle McFarlane brought him to America in 2007. She rode him to the five-gated World Grand Championship, the breed's highest achievement. So he is most definitely a winner, as is his rider, Carson, I shall say. He is a stallion. Countdown is intelligent. He's very enthusiastic and very masculine, but also very much the gentleman. Now almost 20 years old, he still has the class and the charisma of a champion. And this year, in honor of the National Park Service, Michelle McFarlane of Scripps Miramar Ranch is driving an authentic Yellowstone Park wagon designed to carry sightseers around the park. She, her passengers, and her five outriders are all wearing their cowboy best for America's biggest and best New Year's Day celebration. The horses are American saddlebreds, the most elegant and athletic horse shows in the world. Michelle specializes in breeding these flashy, multi-talented horses. Now, Yellowstone is the world's first national park, established in 1872 by President Ulysses S. Grant. 11 years later, so many tourists were eager to view the park that the Yellowstone Park Transportation Company had been commissioned, and they had several wagons built. Their design depended on the terrain and the number of people that they could accommodate. All were made by Abbott and Downing, the famous stagecoach builders. Michelle has two of their stagecoaches in her collection. Now, in 1903, President Theodore Roosevelt, one of the national park system's greatest patrons, interrupted a national speaking tour to spend 2 weeks camping in Yellowstone Park. Now, but according to some black and white photographs taken during the trip, Roosevelt did not particularly care for the wagons. No, he was a rough rider, remember, so he traveled by horseback. Now today, it is still possible to view Yellowstone on horseback or by sitting in a hay wagon. But the wagon probably won't look much like this one that you see before you. Today's sightseers won't look much like these drivers or riders either. And their horses certainly won't look as magnificent or as beautiful as these unique Scripps Miramar bred spotted saddlebreds. Stunning and beautiful. Thank you so much, Michelle. Now, Carson wants everyone to know that they are in barn number 4. So you can go see Carson and Casey's Final Countdown. Look at him go. Woo! Wow. Visit them in barn number 4 after the show. How many of you would like to go to Yellowstone Park and ride in style like that? Oh yeah, me too. Now next up, how many of you have seen in the parade the LA County Sheriff's team? Ah, not enough. So you're in for a treat today. And here they come.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You having a good time? All right. I'm Sergeant Dave Sauer with Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department Mounted Enforcement Detail. And we're going to have some fun with you today while we're getting set up. You know, back in the day when LA sheriffs began, there was more than one horse for every man. And a saddle was part of a deputy's gear. And riding is how you got from there to here. A cop on a horse is not so common today. A dying breed, some might say. But thanks to a few deputy sheriffs and reserves, riding is still how some of us serve. The Mounted Enforcement Detail has 5 full-time members that they ride horses as their radio car every day. And we have another 20 members who are collaterally assigned from various units on the Sheriff's Department. And we have a bunch of those folks here with us today. The primary mission of the Mounted Enforcement Detail is to help keep the many LA County parks safe and fun for people to enjoy. Many of those have equestrian facilities just like Eaton Canyon, not far from where we are right now. Our story today begins in one of those parks with a family enjoying the beautiful, sunny, brisk Southern California air, walking their pony and enjoying time with Grandpa. A nice day in the park. And now it looks like we've got some other people wanting to enjoy the park as well. But I don't know. They look like they might be trouble. Uh-oh. They're wearing hoodies, and it looks like they're harassing our family of parkgoers. What do you think about that crowd? Boo! That's not nice. That's not nice. Look, they took their bag. Harassing those poor little kids. All right, he's running from them. But it looks like he's jumping into the Find Your Adventure transporter. Something's gonna happen, because he said he'd be back.
Thank you so much.
Sometimes it's not the days. The people are
It's like having a
And it looks like they grew up. They grew up to be big cowboys. And they've got some friends. Enforcement detail deputies did an arrest circle around our recalcitrant park goers, and now they're going to escort them out of the vicinity. Let's hear it for them. Oh, one's trying to get away. He's not getting too far. I think that was 8.2 seconds. Is that a record?
I'm a cowboy. I'm a steel horse.
let's hear it for our heroes on horseback who saved the day.
Well, the LA County Sheriff's Posse is putting a little bit of fun in what is serious business as they use horses to control crowds. And it's something that we see from coast to coast, horses used in mounted patrol units across the nation, and horses serve a big purpose. We'll be back with more beautiful horses, including the Budweiser Clydesdales, here at Equestfest in just a moment.
You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
Well, there's lots more horses to come here on Equestfest, including the famous Norco Cowgirls and the Budweiser Clydesdales. But right now are some horses that are coming into the arena that are from my neck of the woods in Fort Hood, Texas. This is the U.S. Army 1st Cavalry.
From Fort Hood, Texas, the United States Army 1st Cavalry Horse Detachment.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Sergeant Schwalbe from Orange County, California, with the United States Army 1st Cavalry Division Horse Cavalry Detachment. On behalf of Lieutenant General Sean B. McFarland, Commander 3 Corps and Fort Hood, and Major General Michael A. Bills, Commander of the 1st Cavalry Division, I would like to welcome you to today's Mounted Cavalry Demonstration. For over 200 years, the cavalry has served the United States as its most mobile, most versatile form of combat. In fact, the cavalry is still known as the Combat Arm of Decision. The 1st Cavalry Division was formed... The 1st Cavalry Division was formed by combining four of the U.S. Cavalry regiments to help settle the West after the Civil War. Serving the public for the past four decades, the horse detachment has traveled throughout the United States, appearing on request in ceremonies, parades, rodeos, and other various celebrations to include the inaugural parades of our former presidents Ronald Reagan and George W. Bush. As tradition dictates, we have attempted to keep our mounts matched in size and color with the minimum amount of white markings. All of our horses are saddle broke before being accepted by the detachment, yet it is found that not all horses adapt to this type of work. With the mechanization of the 20th century, new challenges came forth that forever changed the face of war. As war became more and more technically advanced, it became harder to make effective use of our horses, and so sadly, we had to retire the faithful mounts that served us so well. But today, even though we may drive a tank or fly a helicopter, the heritage we bear has not been forgotten. In fact, we keep our mounts with us, constantly reminding us, even though the face of war may shift and change, still, we are the cavalry! Order drill demonstrating a part of the School of the Soldier Mounted, taken from the Army's Cavalry Drill and Tactics Manual, dated 1874. During the demonstration, Captain Rascone would lead the demo team through various drill movements. The movements will be conducted at a walk, a trot, a gallop, and negotiating fouls, columns of twos, and fours. Will bring the troopers into columns of twos. The next command, four and fours, places the detachment into a column of fours. Fours right and left from into a line, place the detachment on line with the commander and the guide on bearer in the center. Ladies and gentlemen, this drill is the inverted wagon wheel. The troopers pivot in the center as the ranks pass between each other in opposite directions. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the cavalry. Fours forward is another method of bringing the detachment into a column of fours. The detachment will now conduct a counter-column movement. This drill is used to reverse the direction of the detachment. The drill you are watching now is twos from the center, left and right about. Reverse of the previous drill is twos to the center, left and right about. This drill is the wagon wheel, where the riders and mounts perform a wheelie movement in unison. Coming out of the wagon wheel, the detachment will turn into a column of twos in preparation for the next drill. Fowl's turn left and right about is another method of reversing the direction of the detachment. The next row you'll see is circles by file, where each fowl conducts two circles to the left and right as each rider meets up with his partner at the center of the course.
Coming out of the circles, the detachment will again form into a column of twos in preparation for the next drill. You are now watching the crisscross. It is formed in two columns of troopers galloping in figures of eight in opposite directions, thereby crossing paths at the center of the course. Crisscross, Captain Ruscombe will prepare for the gallery drill, in which the commander, Guy Dalbert, and first sergeant ride off to the left rear, while the rest of the demonstration teams rides to the right front. The separate elements will each gallop through figures of eight, with the command element passing through the center of the demo team. Bringing the demonstration team back together, Captain Ruscombe will direct files left and right. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our drill and ceremony demonstration, but don't go away because the 1st Cavalry Division, Horse Cavalry Detachment, will be performing a weapons demonstration at the end of Equestfest. Thank you and enjoy the rest of the event.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the U.S. Army 1st Cavalry.
I'm glad those guys are on our side.
I know, right?
That's right. Now, the soldiers of the 1st Cavalry Horse Division want you to know that at the conclusion of the formal Equestfest lineup today, they will be back in the arena to perform some very special maneuvers. So, at the end of the show, if you would like to watch them, a little more up close and personal and see them do more things, please stay here in the Equidome, and I think you'll have quite a treat. Hang around.
All right, well, the theme for this year's Tournament of Roses Parade is Find Your Adventure.
And of course, you know, Carson, you can find your adventure in one of our beautiful, incredible national parks.
I do.
Thank you, gentlemen. Do you have a favorite national park?
I really like Acadia National Park in Maine. That's one of my favorite. They have driving trails where you can drive horses or you can ride bikes, and it's really good.
Oh my gosh, I need to go.
Yes, you must.
All right, well, many of you may know they are celebrating their 100th birthday this year. Let's hear it for the 100th birthday of our National Park Service.
We are the National Park Service, and we're here to celebrate the beginning of our second century with you. The world has changed a lot since August 25th, 1916, when President Woodrow Wilson signed the Organic Act, protecting for their grandchildren, and now our grandchildren, some of America's greatest treasures. Yeah, a lot has changed, but the mission of our national parks, our heritage as Americans, hasn't changed all that much. And in some ways, neither have we. At the start of our first century, we used wagons just like this to bring adventurous visitors to the parks, and mules to supply remote outposts, to carry the materials that built the first roads, and to help us access much of the wild western wilderness. We still do. And as we've now had 100 years to practice packing those mules, we think we're pretty darn good at it. And not only are we good at it, but at this point, we can get a mule packed and down a trail pretty darn quick. But even in a group of really fast packers, there's got to be one who's just the fastest. And today, in honor of our 100th birthday, we've brought our two fastest packers, and we're gonna stage a little competition right here in front of you to see who's going to start this new century as the fastest packer in the National Park Service. So on my left, we have Dennis Dozier, ladies and gentlemen, 35 years in service, one-time Bishop Mule Days champion packer. And on our right, Shane Fairbanks, Yosemite Corral manager. It's a battle of age against beauty as they race to pack a mule as fast as they can. On your mark, get set, pack. Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen. Pack!
That's because I said that.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen. The louder you cheer, the faster they pack. Let's hear it. Definitely won this time. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, America's parks are your shared inheritance. Get out there and find your park. And cheers to another 100 years with all of you. We'd like to thank the Yosemite Conservancy and all of those who helped us get here today to another 100 years.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the National Park Service of the United States of America.
Woo-hoo! Okay, so I have to tell you my favorite national park.
Oh, please do.
Yes. Well, it is, oh, thank you, Lee. Can we hear it for Lee? This is the producer of our show, ladies and gentlemen, who's also from medieval times. Take a bow, Lee. I'm gonna embarrass you, thank you very much. I'm gonna be in big trouble now. Oh yeah, he's like, come on, if you're gonna do it right! I have to say, I know it sounds cliche, but Yosemite, it took my breath away.
I need to go there, I've never been.
Oh my gosh, yes. Does he need to go to Yosemite?
I need to go to Yosemite.
This East Coast boy needs to go to Yosemite. Yes. Yes, it's beautiful. Coming up next, ooh, I think it's going to get loud. It's the U.S. Army Field Artillery
half section.
An American guide, we'll always stand up and salute. We'll always recognize and feel there's a lot of men dead, so we can sleep in peace at night when we lay down our heads. My daddy served in the army. We lost his right eye, but he flew a flag out in our yard till the day that he died. He wanted my mother, my brother, my sister, and me to grow up and
ladies and gentlemen, from Fort Sill, Oklahoma, the Fort Sill Artillery Half Section. This colorful horse-drawn unit depicts the historic period of World War I. The uniforms are authentic examples of the post-war era.
Well, this unit consists of a four-horse hitch that pulls a French 75-millimeter cannon and limber with the chief of section and the Gideon bearer on separate mounts. The three off-horses in the team are ridden by the cannoneers if the cannon is unable to function.
Personnel of the half section are hand-picked soldiers and on duty with the half section for 1 year.
Well, I think we woke up the neighbors.
I think so. We're waking them up and shaking them up. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to shake things up some more.
Nicely done, gentlemen. I think what we have to remember is all of our riders today, you included, make it look so easy, but it is not. It takes years of experience. Wow, I can't do that either.
No, they're real pros.
Wow, I can't do that either. They are pros.
They are the U.S. Army Field Artillery Unit, everybody, from Fort Sill, Oklahoma.
I cannot tell you how unnatural it is for horses to stand for all the cannons and shooting that we've seen here today. But all of these horses enjoy their jobs, and they are well trained. And there will be more beautiful horses coming up here on Equestfest. Keep it right here on RFD TV.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more from the Equestfest on RFD TV. You're watching RFD TV and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses presentation of Equestfest.
Well, we are here at the Los Angeles Equestrian Center, and Equestfest 2015 is winding down, but you don't want to miss what's happening next. Coming into the arena from right down the road, Norco, they call that Horsetown USA. There's even hitching posts in front of nearly every business in Norco, California. These are the Norco Cowgirls.
There is a little town not too far away from like downtown Los Angeles known as Horsetown, USA. Okay, they are a favorite every year at Equestfest. Here they are from Norco, California, better known as Horsetown, USA. It is the Norco Cowgirls.
Hey, girl.
Woo!
Till the break of dawn, the DJ's spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shake it for the birds, shake it for the birds.
How about a round of applause for the Norco Cowgirls Rodeo Drill Team and the Little Miss Norco Cowgirls Junior Drill Team. They're sponsored by Inland Vet Supply, and they'll be making their fourth appearance in the Rose Parade New Year's Day with their junior drill team for the first time participating this year. The Little Misses are age 9 through 16. There are 5 mother-daughter pairs riding on the teams and 1 3-generation trio. The Norco Cowgirls can't think of a better way for the Little Misses to find their adventure than to share the Rose Parade adventure with them. And they're thrilled to be performing for you today. And the louder you cheer, the harder they ride, everybody. So make some noise if you like what you see. The Little Misses are wearing red, white, and blue, and the Norco Cowgirls are in blue and white.
August of 2008 by Michonne Bowen, the Norco Cowgirls Rodeo Drill Team has made over 180 appearances to date. Devoted to their horses and to being the number one drill team in California, the team's goals are to have fun, build friendships, excel in their horsemanship, and to represent Norco, Horsetown, USA.
Now the Cowgirls will be making their fourth appearance in the Rose Parade New Year's Day. You may have seen the Norco Cowgirls on RFD TV, at the San Bernardino, Norco, Industry Hills, San Dimas, or Hesperia PRCA Rodeos, or the California Circuit Finals. During their first appearance in the Rose Parade, they captured the attention of the producers of Small Town Big Deal and brought the show to Norco.
Yes, I have to mention that I was so pleased and so proud to put them on our show because they are such a dedicated group. They are lovely. Small Town Big Deal says, hello, girls. And you have really grown since we saw you and had you on our show. Congratulations. The Cowgirls love being role models for younger girls and have recently formed this junior drill team for girls ages 7 through 14, those Little Miss Norco Cowgirls, and they are riding with them today. Thank you. Find them on Facebook and give them a like. Thank you, Norco Cowgirls. Thank you, Michonne. Those girls can ride.
They look like they have fun, too.
I want to party with them.
Mm-hmm. We're going to have to find them after the show.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. And again, I was so proud to have them on our show.
Well, they know how to get the party started, right?
I would say. Now, what's a party without a little refreshment?
Well, yeah, and what better way to have your refreshment delivered than by our next guests?
Oh, how might you have your beer delivered?
Well, I would personally like to have it delivered by the famous, world-renowned Budweiser Clydesdales.
And ladies and gentlemen, entering the arena now, our beloved, all-American, Budweiser Clydesdales! Watching 8 tons of champions, the beautifully matched 8 horse hitch from Anheuser-Busch Brewery, driven by Doug Brusolo and assisted by Todd Rockmeyer. Now, notice how effortlessly the driver handles the hitch. He holds the 4 pair of reins laced through the fingers of each hand, giving him individual control over each horse.
Each pair of horses in the hitch has a specific job to perform as part of the team. The front pair are called the lead team and are smaller and more active than the other horses because they have to cover the most territory in turns and do it in the fastest time. The second pair are the swing horses. They are slightly larger than the lead horses, but they are just as agile and active because of the area they have to cover in making turns. The third pair are called the body horses. They again are slightly larger than the swing pair because they have to help pull more of the load. The pair closest to the wagon are called the wheel horses. They are the largest of the four pairs because they have to hold the wagon back while the other horses make the turn.
Clydesdales are extremely intelligent, beautifully mannered, and trained to perfection. They're also exceptionally gentle, despite the fact that they dwarf ordinary horses in size. The average age of these Clydesdales is 4 to 9 years. Their average height is 18 hands, which is about 6 feet at shoulder height. The average weight of a Clydesdale, 2,000 pounds. Watch how the Clydesdales maneuver the wagon. They make it look like a toy. And would you believe that that wagon weighs 3.5 tons?
This is a very special maneuver called the figure eight coming up. The driver is guiding the hitch into a figure eight. In performing this maneuver, the driver controls each pair of horses individually, starting them into the turn at different times. He starts his lead horses turning into the direction of the first loop of the figure eight. At the same time, he turns the next pair, the swing horses, slightly in the opposite direction, and then he brings them around behind the lead pair. The body horses, the third pair in the hitch, are gradually brought into the turn, and finally, the wheel horses will make their move, turning the wagon with them. Having made the first loop of the figure eight, then the driver reverses the procedure, turning in the opposite direction to complete the maneuver. And once again, he will guide each horse separately into their turn. I know. They make it look so easy, and it is so not. And in case you've been thinking about getting your own Clydesdale hitch, you might be interested to know that the harnesses alone cost well over $80,000 for all of them. It is all handmade and decorated extensively with brass ornamentation. In fact, at a beautiful place called Shanahan Harness in Ohio. Now, when on the road, the Budweiser Clydesdales travel in a caravan in 3 tractor trailers. Ooh, this is traveling in style, Carson. Each van is 45 feet long and 8 feet wide. In the two-horse vans, all stalls face forward and are arranged so that the horses cannot be thrown off balance. And the third van is used to transport the huge brass-trimmed wagon, portable stalls, and other necessary equipment.
Now, we can't forget the Dalmatian dog sitting on the wagon. That's the official mascot of the hitch. His name is Chip, and he goes everywhere the team goes. And that takes in about 30,000 miles a year. Okay. Now, this is a really cool part of their performance as well. If you remain quiet, you can hear the driver giving the horses their commands for the docking procedure. Now, the driver is going to simulate days of old when hitches were used to make deliveries and had to back up to loading docks. He pulled his wagon up to the position on where he'll have to dock, and then he swings the horses around so the wagon is perpendicular to the dock. Once the wagon is in position for loading or unloading at the dock, the driver will swing the complete 8-horse hitch 90 degrees, a maneuver he would have to do to clear the street for traffic. Now the driver will simulate clearing a dock space for another wagon to move in by swinging the entire hitch 180 degrees, facing them in the opposite position without moving the wagon.
Okay, that is amazing. I think that it's ready for a big woohoo!
Big round of applause.
And that is how it's done.
Right.
We are so excited everywhere when you all come. Every year we just love it. How much does Southern California love the Clydesdales? And how much does Southern California love Budweiser?
Folks, you're seeing a high spot of a bygone era, the Budweiser Clydesdales in all their glory, just the way your grandparents remember them. Let's give them a big hand, the champion of champions, the Budweiser Clydesdales. And of course, we can't forget their drivers, Doug Busolo and Todd Rademacher, and of course, their mascot, Chip. Give him a big round of applause.
And you know, to be a Budweiser Clydesdale, you have to have all the special markings. On their feet, they're called feathers. They call that long fur. So they all have to have the white feathers, be bay in color, dark mane and tail, and the white blaze on
right.
their face. They are bred at a special farm in Boonville, Missouri, called Warm Springs. Carson, I have to take you there. I went there once. There
I
were.
No, let's go.
We have to go. There were 23 baby Clydesdales there that day. All hoping to be one of these guys when they grew up.
Right.
Oh, they are on the mark today. We're lucky today. We saw their final, very fantastic maneuver. A very special spiral.
Ladies and gentlemen, make a lot of noise for the world famous Budweiser Clydesdales.
Well done, gentlemen. Beautifully done, beautifully done. You know, we've seen them, if you haven't seen them in person before, when you see them on TV, it's one thing, but when you see those Clydesdales in person, how fabulous is that?
Right, I agree with you, Jen, they are incredible.
This has been an absolutely amazing day. I hope you guys have enjoyed it as much as Carson and I have.
Well, I did, I know that. Well, I can't wait to see all of our Equestfest friends riding in this year's parade, but it's not over yet. In just a minute, the U.S. Army 1st Cavalry will be back in the arena for some very special demonstrations, so do stick around.
That's right, and we would like to thank the Tournament of Roses Equestrian Chair, Ellen Swaggerty, for all she has done to make today a success. A big thank you also to Jeanette Collier of the Tournament House.
And of course, to our band, Dawson, I'm Carson Kressley signing off.
And I'm Jan Carl saying thank you for joining us at Equestfest and an early Happy New Year.
We'll see you guys next year.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks to Jan and Carson for sharing their knowledge with all of us and all of you. We hope you'll join us on New Year's Day for the Tournament of Roses Parade. And remember that RFD TV brings you all the floats, all the bands, and all the horses. Tell a friend. We'll see you on New Year's Day. Bye-bye now.